him shall reap my reward. But do not tarry too long, Reginald. Come in charms or wreck, Reginald. And already they are decaying. Better secure me ere I have gone too far.
Sigh. treacherously these maidens love me. And how hopelessly. Oh, patience. Patience. With the love of you in my heart, what have I for these poor mad maidens but an unvalued pity? Alas, they shall die of hopeless love of me, as I shall die of hopeless love of thee.
Will it please you read to us, sir?
Yes, child. If you wish, what shall I read?
One of your own poems.
One of my own poems? Better not, my child. They will not cure thee of thy love.
Well, Mr. Bunthorne used to read us a poem of his very own every day.
And to do him justice, he read them extremely well.
Oh, did he so? Well, who am I to withhold my gifts from you? What am I but a trustee? Here is a decanet, a pure and simple thing, a very daisy. Even a babe could understand it. To appreciate it, it is not necessary to think of anything at all.
Let us think of nothing at all.
Gentle Jane was good as gold. She always did as she was told. She never spoke when her mouth was full, or caught blue beetles, their legs to pull, or spilt plum jam on her nice new frock, or put white mice in the 8-day clock, or vivisected her last new doll. Or fostered a passion for alcohol. And when she grew up, she was given in marriage to a first-class earl who keeps his carriage. I believe I am right in saying there is not one word in that decollet calculated to bring the blush of shame to the cheek of modesty.
Not a one. It is purity itself.
Here's another. Teasing Tom was a very bad boy. A great big squirt was his favorite toy. He put live shrimps in his father's boots. And sewed up the sleeves of his Sunday suits. He punched his poor little sister's heads. And cayenne peppered their four post beds. He plastered their hair with cobbler's wax and dropped hot hay pennies down their backs. The consequence was he was lost totally and married a girl in the corps de ballet.
Mark you how grandly, how relentlessly the damning catalogue of crime strode on till retribution, like a poisoned hawk, swooped down upon the wrongdoer. Oh, it was terrible. Will you touch our hearts and they go out to you?
This is simply cloying. Ladies, I'm sorry to appear ungallant, but it is Saturday, and you have been following me about ever since Monday. I should like the usual half holiday. I would consider it a personal favor if you allowed me to close early today.
Oh, sir, do not send us from you.
These poor girls. is best to speak plainly. Ladies, I know that I am loved by you. But never can I love you in return, for I have fixed my fancy elsewhere. Remember you the fable of the magnet and the churn?
But we don't know the fable of the magnet and the churn.
Don't you? Then I will sing it to you. Scissors and needles, nails and knives, offering love for all their lives. But for iron the magnet held no weight. Loki charmed, iron it charmed not him. For me it was nails and knives he turned, for he set his love on a silver churn.
A silver churn.
A silver churn. It's most aesthetic, very magnetic, fancy to next turn. If I can wheedle a knife or a needle, why not a silver churn?
It's most aesthetic, very magnetic, fancy to next turn. If I can wheedle a knife or a needle, why not a silver churn?
And iron and steel express their surprise. The needles opened their well-drilled eyes. The penknives felt shot up, no doubt. The scissors declared themselves covered out. The kettles, they boiled with rage to say. While every bay put off its play, and hither and thither began to roam, till a hammer came up and drove them home.
It drove them home.
It drove them home. While this magnetic, pathetic lover lives to learn, by no endeavor can magnet ever attract a silver churn.
While this magnetic, pathetic lover lives to learn, by no endeavor can magnet ever attract.
So
Sylvia.
Damsel, you are!
Oh, not pretty. Massive.
Please. And no doubt I am a highly spiced.
Not the lightest.
Though, for the act of death. But I'll show the world that I can be as mild-mannered as he is. If they want insipidity, they shall have it. I'll meet this fellow on his own ground and beat him on it.
You shall, and I will help you.
You will? Why, Jane, there's a great deal of good in you after all.
So go to him and say to him, I can't help what I want to call him.
Hey, good day, and that's what I will say.
Your song is not too simple for your conscience to come on to call him.
But I'm hot, and that's what I shall say.
What's the new idea of the boy that's that? To have my inspiration, what's the value of all that? So you cut me up with your facility in intervals.
Sing hey, good day, and that's what I shall say. Sing mint, poop pint, and that's what I shall say.
Sing hey,
thank you.
lasting impression on these ladies is to become as aesthetic as they are.
No doubt. The only question is, how far I succeed in doing so. I don't know why, but I have an idea this is not quite right.
I don't like it, I never did. I don't know what it means. I do it, but I don't like it.
My good friend, the question is not whether we like it, but whether they do. They understand these things, we don't. Now, I shouldn't be surprised if this is effective enough. At a distance.
At it. It'd be extremely awkward if we were to be struck so.
I don't think we should be struck so. Perhaps we're a little awkward at it. But everything must have a beginning. Now, here they come. Turn, jump!
Thank you.
will have to be contented with a heartfelt sympathy.
He will have to be contented with a heartfelt sympathy.
I see that you had.
Mr. Bunthorne, by the memory of that aunt, I implore you, pause ere you resort to this last fearful expedient. Help, reflect, Mr. Bunthorne, reflect!
I must not allow myself to be unmanned. It is useless. Consent at once, or may I yet use
power! Are you absolutely resolved?
Absolutely.
Will nothing sway you?
Oh, nothing, I am adamant.
Very well, then I yield.
What, sir?
I do cheerfully. I have long since searched for a reasonable pretext to effect such a change as you have suggested, and it comes at last. I do it on compulsion.
Victory! I triumph! When I blew up the door, the dam was out to score. I'll sigh and yearn and tickle and venture upon the Yasmin ball. I shall the culture taste, the stainless gems of piss, and hide the dinnable rank as a dinner of my pronouncement taste.
A most intense man, a soulful iron man, an ultra poetical, super aesthetical, out of the way of man.
Conceive me if you can, in everything a man, a commonplace type with a stick and a pipe and a hat red, black and tan, who thinks suburban hops more fun than Monday pops, who's fond of his dinner and doesn't get to dinner on walls of beer and trots. An everyday young man, a matter of fact young man, a steady and solid jolly psychology, an everyday young man.
A Japanese young man, a few in a white young man, a Francesca's a living, ebony, jealous of bar young man.
A sensory lane young man, a sunset house young man, a very delectable, highly respectable, freaking bus young man.
A hag in a lake for man, a pound of pin for man, a green or a yellow, he drove in a gallery, foot in the grave for man.
A chancery lane young man, a howling king young man, offers a young article, what's the next article, weekly bus young man.
Receive me if you can, in every day young man, an alphabetical and a statistical every day young man. Receive me if you can, in every day young man, I know what the badge is in this national every day you're gone.
It is all right. I have committed my last act of ill nature and am henceforth to change character.
Thank you.
grace. I have sworn it.
There's nothing to prevent my loving you with all the fervor in my prayer.
Why, that's true. My patience.
Rushed again.
Cheer up.
I shall have to